It was quite stunning to me the first time I went into a slum environment, and you know, when you think about what you see in that sort of environment, where you see the total dire poverty, not something that had ever, I guess, crossed my mind. Even, you know, you see pictures on the television, but it's a very different thing when you sit there and or you walk through these slum environments, and you see the terrible quality of housing. You see houses built over kind of rivers of filth, and you see pigs living in the houses, and you see, you know, just all sorts of things that I found very challenging.
So we went into this little village and went into a basic hut with a dirt floor, and there was a mother with a baby who was obviously in distress. That was quite confronting. Then we sort of gave some money to the ICM staff, saying, you know, this baby needs to get to a hospital. The baby hadn't made it, passed away.
Probably the most striking was walking on stilts through what was called the second poorest slum in all of the Philippines.
There was a slum area. I remember it was low tide, and I looked down. There were all kinds of gunk in there, human waste, you know, all kinds of unpleasant sights, and you have to be really careful when you walk through those quote unquote bridge, which kind of made up of bamboo, and then as you go into the slum, and the living condition was quite terrible. And then a few months ago, I went there, and we went to stop by in the same slum. And at this time it was high tide, and I thought low tide was bad. High tide was even worse, you know. I guess all the unpleasant things kind of flow to the, you know, surface.
It stunk. It made you want to retch, to be honest with you.
People in the slums, they were planning for the end of the day. Can I get enough money from some job that I'm doing, or making rice cakes that I'm selling in some stall, to get enough money to buy some rice to eat this evening? A very hand-to-mouth existence.
I want to be a doctor in the Philippines because I want to help poor people.
The first time I was invited to go on a vision trip, I actually didn't want to go. And that's because I don't like seeing things that are not pleasant. And I don't like seeing things that will make me change my life. And I knew that that's what I was going to see.
Probably the biggest impression that happened when I was there were the children. And I think for me, I respond really emotionally to children. That really humbled me. And it's really difficult for me, especially to see children in poverty. And that is an experience that I won't forget.
I guess that first visit did end up changing my life. I'm now the executive director here in Hong Kong of ICM. I love ICM and I love the people that work for ICM. We've got nearly 200 staff down in the Philippines that put all of our plans into action. And our plan is to bring hope, long-term change to an entire community. We have feeding, medical, livelihood, preschool programs that all make huge impact. I don't want to go down and keep visiting slums. I don't want to keep showing people slums. We want to see new communities. We want to bring hope.
These people see a new home.
And you can see a change in their attitude. You can see that the people now have hope. You can see that they really believe that, you know, there is a future, or there's potential for them.
It's not just about putting a spoon of rice in some baby's mouth, but you're giving that child the care, the development, and the encouragement, and the opportunities to grow.
I see the hope to the recipients.
People's lives has been changed. People's lives has been transformed. Those that are, they think they are hopeless.
Giving them the help, we could give them the hope.
I've seen hope in their faces.